Good morning, all of you. My name is Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. And today I'm dealing with magnetic boundary conditions in my third lecture. So the outline is magnetic boundary conditions. So in previous units, we have already studied the concepts of boundary conditions with respect to electric field. Now, today we will deal with the boundary conditions with respect to magnetic field. So the conditions of the magnetic field existing at the boundary of the two media when the magnetic field passes from one medium to other are called as magnetic boundary conditions. So there are two mediums, medium one and medium two. And we are studying the magnetic field which passes from one medium to another medium across the boundary. So the conditions at the boundary of B and H are considered, and both vectors are resolved into two components. One is normal to boundary and the second one is tangential to boundary. So the magnetic boundary conditions we are going to study with respect to two components. One is normal component and second one is tangential component. So this is the diagram for both normal component as well as a tangential component. Now here is the boundary level and there are two medium. So this is medium one and this is medium two. That is, medium one is having the value as mu one and medium two has a value mu two. So there are two mediums as a mu one and mu two, and there is a boundary between two mediums. So this is the boundary line. So let us study both normal component as well as tangential component one by one. So let me start with the first concept, that is normal component. So to study the normal component, let us see this structure wherein which there are two fluxes. One is BN1 and another one is BN2. Now BN1 is flux in the first medium and BN2 is in the second medium. And there is a surface area for this cylinder structure, that is delta S. So now we will see how to derive the equations for normal component. Now according to Gauss law, for the magnetic field, we know that B dot ds is equal to zero for a surface charge, yes. So if we apply the Gauss law conditions across the boundary of Bn1 as well as Bn2, we can write this as Bn1 delta s, that is B dot ds, Bn1 delta s minus Bn2 delta s, that is delta S remains same for both the mediums, but Bn1 is in another direction with respect to Bn2. That means we can write it as Bn1 minus Bn2. This is in another medium, Bn2. So we will write this as Bn1 minus Bn2. That is delta S. So we can write this as bn1 delta s minus bn2 delta s is equal to 0. This is according to Gauss law, that is b dot ds is equal to 0. Now since delta s component, that is area, is same whether you take a medium 1 or a medium 2, we will write this as bn1 is equal to bn2. That means the magnetic flux density, the normal component bn1 is equal to bn2 across the boundary conditions or the boundary line. Now we know that b is equal to mu into h. So bn2 we will write it as mu2 hn2, and bn1 we can write it as mu1 hn1. So we will write this equation in terms of h as hn2 is equal to mu1 divided by mu2 into hn1. That means this is in terms of flux and this is in terms of field intensity, that is h. Now with this normal to boundary, we will move to the next concept, that is tangential to boundary. Now here we will apply the Ampere's circuit law. Now for this we will see a line segment delta L. HT1 is a field intensity in first medium, HT2 is in second medium, and delta L is the line segment. Now this is the direction in first medium and this is the direction in second medium. Now since the line integral for a closed path H dot dl is equal to current I according to Ampere's circuit law, now if we apply this across the boundary, then for the first medium we can write it as HT1 delta L, and for the second medium it is HT2 delta L. But since delta L is in opposite direction, we will write this as HT1 delta L minus HT2 delta L is equal to K into delta L, where K is actually the surface current. Now we will see here where we assume that the boundary may carry a surface current K whose component normal to the plane of the closed path is K. Hence we will use this K as the surface current across the element delta L, and we can write this equation using Ampere's circuit law. We can write the equation at the boundary as for the tangential component HT1 delta L minus HT2 delta L is equal to K into delta L. Now delta L will get cancelled and this equation becomes HT1 minus HT2 is equal to K. Now again we can represent this field intensity in terms of flux density also, that is B is equal to mu into H. Hence HT1 can be written as BT1 divided by mu1 minus HT2 is BT2 divided by mu2 is equal to K. So in the tangential component we will get the value as K, that is nothing but the current, but in case of normal component it is 0, because Gauss law B dot ds is equal to 0 for a closed path. But for the Ampere's law, for a closed path H dot dl is equal to current I. Hence we will get some component here, that is the current value. Now we can write this equation as HT1 minus HT2 is equal to AN12 cross K. Now what is this AN12? That is the unit normal at the boundary directed from region 1 to region 2. So this is normal to boundary, that is unit normal component from medium 1 to medium 2, that is AN12. So we can write this in tangential component as ht1 minus ht2 is equal to an12 cross k. So this is how we will deal with both normal component as well as a tangential component, and both with respect to h as well as b, that is intensity as well as flux density. Now we will see some numericals based on this normal as well as tangential component to understand in depth about the boundary conditions. Now let us take the first example, that is find the normal component of the magnetic field which traverses from medium 1 to medium 2 having mu r1 is equal to 2.5 and mu r2 is equal to 4, and it is given that h is equal to minus 30 ax plus 50 ay plus 70 az ampere per meter in medium 1, and the interface of the two media is the xy plane. Now there is an interface between two media in xy plane. They have given the value of h, that is field intensity, and there are two medium, medium 1 and medium 2, with the mu r1 and mu r2 as 2.5 and 4 respectively. Now from this h I need to calculate the normal component. So if I say normal component, then the normal component will be in medium 1 also, as well as it is in medium 2 also. So let us calculate first in medium 1, because they have directly given the value of h in medium 1, that is minus 30 ax plus 50 ay plus 70 az in medium 1, and the interface is xy plane. Then what happens? For the normal component will be only z component, because the interface is xy plane. That means in the given value of h, minus 30 ax plus 50 ay plus 70 az, only 70 az we need to consider as a normal component, because the interface is in which plane? Xy plane. So leaving xy component, we need to consider only the z component, that is 70 az will be my normal component of the h in medium 1. Now if I need in medium 2, then I need to apply the equation what we have derived in normal to boundary, that is bn1 is equal to bn2. So bn1 is equal to bn2 means mu1 hn1 is equal to mu2 hn2, because b is equal to mu into h. So bn1 is equal to mu1 h1 and bn2 is equal to mu2 hn2. So hn1 divided by hn2 is equal to mu2 by mu1. Anyway, mu0 value will get cancelled in both numerator as well as denominator. Hence mu2 by mu1 is equal to mu2 value. Mu2 value is 4 and mu1 value is 2.5. 4 divided by 2.5, I will get it as 1.6. Now from this, I will calculate the value of hn2. That is hn2 is equal to hn1 divided by 1.6, that is equal to hn1 is 70. That is, we have already calculated 70 az, the component is 70 divided by 1.6, that is mu2 by mu1. And from this I will get 43.75, that is my hn2, that is 43.75 az. Ampere per meter will be the unit. That means it is normal component will be only in which direction? Az direction, that is az components will retain, because the interface is xy plane. So this is how we are going to do the example. Now let us take one more example, second example. Now consider an interface in yz plane. Now the plane is yz. Then the region x is less than 0 is medium one, with mu r1 is equal to 4.5, and the magnetic field H1 is equal to 4ax plus 3ay minus 6az ampere per meter. That is, medium one is x is less than 0, mu r1 they have given as 4.5, as well as H1 in case of first medium for x is less than 0. Now, next sentence, that is, the region x is greater than 0 is medium 2, that is second medium, with the mu r2 is equal to 6. Now, find H2 in medium 2 and angle made by H2 with normal to the interface. Now, first I need to calculate the value of H2 in medium 2. And along with that, I need to calculate the angle made by this H2 with the normal to the interface. Let us proceed with the numerical. Now, from the given H, first let me write both the tangential as well as normal component. The given H is in first medium, that is medium 1. And it is in which plane? YZ plane. The interface is in YZ plane. Since it is in YZ plane, what is the normal component and tangential component? The tangential component will be 3ay minus 6az. That means only y and z component will retain. And the normal component will be 4ax. Ax component will retain. That is ampere per meter, both normal component as well as tangential component. Now we have seen the tangential to boundary, wherein which the tangential component with respect to field intensity are equal. That is, H tangential 1 is equal to H tangential 2, that is equal to 3ay minus 6az ampere per meter. That is, tangential components are equal in case of boundary. Now, the normal component with respect to H, it is discontinuous, because with respect to B, we have defined the normal component, that is Bn1 is equal to Bn2. But with respect to H, it is mu1 Hn1 is equal to mu2 Hn2, that is Bn1 is equal to Bn2. Hence, Hn1 by Hn2 is equal to mu2 divided by mu1, that is equal to mu0 mu r2 by mu0 mu r1. Mu0 value will get cancelled both in numerator as well as denominator. Now, substitute the value of mu r2 and mu r1. Mu r2 they have given as 6, and mu r1 value they have given as 4.5. Now, from this, we can calculate Hn2, because Hn1 we have already defined from the given equation itself. Both Hn1 and Htan1, tangential component. And also Htan2 also we have defined, because both are equal. Now, I need Hn2, that is, Hn2 is equal to mu1 by mu2, that is 4.5 divided by 6 into Hn1, and I will get this as the normal component is, value is 3. Now, the normal component Hn1 we have defined in which direction, which component we have taken? Ax component, because the interface is yz plane. Hence, our Hn2 will also become as 3ax ampere per meter. That is Hn1. So now we got all the values, that is Hn1, Hn2 and Htan1 as well as Htan2. Now the question is, they are asking us to calculate the value of H2 in medium 1 and also the angle made by H2. Now, what is H2 in medium 2? That is both tangential component as well as normal component. Including that, I will get the total value of H2. Hence, H2 is equal to tangential component of second medium as well as normal component. And tangential component we have already calculated as 3ay minus 6az. And normal component is 3ax. So we will write total H as Hn2 plus H tan 2 is equal to 3ax plus 3ay minus 6az ampere per meter will be my H2 value, that is in medium 2. Now along with H2, I need to calculate the angle made by H2 with the normal to the interface. And let us define the angle as alpha 2. Let me define the angle as alpha 2. Then we can write this equation as H2 dot AX is equal to H2 AX, that is mod value of H2, mod value of AX cos alpha 2. Only AX, because the Hn1 as well as Hn2 both are only having AX component because the interface is YZ plane. Hence, I have taken only AX component. And I will get it as H2 value, that is 3AX plus 3AY minus 6AZ. 3ax plus 3ay minus 6z substitute ax component as it is equal to mod value of H2, that is 3 square plus 3 square minus 6 square into mod value of ax is 1 and cos alpha 2 as it is. Now we will calculate this dot product, that is ax component, ax with ax will retain, that is 3. And all other values, that ax.ay and ax.az, will become 0. So left side, I will get only 3, that is equal to under root of magnitude. I need 3 square plus 3 square plus minus 6 square cos alpha 2. So I will get this value as 7.3484 cos alpha 2. Now cos alpha 2 is equal to 3 divided by 7.3484. That is equal to 0.4082. And from this, we can calculate alpha 2 is equal to cos inverse of 0.4082. That is equal to 65.9 degree will be the angle made to the interface. That is normal to the interface. So this is very important numerical for the point of exam, wherein which along with H, they are asking us to calculate the angle made by this normal to the interface. And this is how we are calculating the H value as well as the angle value. Now let us take one more numerical, wherein which here I have defined only the field intensity. Next one, let us take in terms of flux density B. Now to illustrate with respect to flux density B, now to illustrate these relationships with an example, let us assume that mu1 is equal to 4. That is micro Henry per meter they have given in region 1, where the region 1 is Z is greater than 0, whereas mu2 value is 7 micro Henry per meter in region 2, wherever Z is less than 0. And they have also given the value of K, that is, moreover, let K is equal to 80 AX ampere per meter on the surface, Z is equal to 0. And we establish a field. Field we have to consider as B1 is equal to 2AX minus 3AY plus AZ milli Tesla in region 1, and we need to calculate, that is seek the value of B2 in medium 2. So medium 1, region 1 is Z is greater than 0. Medium 2 is Z is less than 0. They have given both the values, mu 1 value as well as mu 2 value. They have given the value of B1, that is in region 1, medium 1. And we need to calculate the value of B2 in medium 2. And they have given the value of K, that we have seen already, surface current. K is equal to 80 AX ampere per meter they have given. K value. Now let us solve step by step. Let me find out first normal component. Now, the normal component of B1. What is the normal component of B1? Now the region is defining with respect to Z. That is Z is greater than 0, Z is less than 0. They have defined both the mediums. Hence, the normal component of B1 is only which component? Yes, it is only AZ component. So from the given equation of B1, only AZ component will retain as it is. That is AZ milli Tesla will be the normal component, because they have given the region in terms of Z is less than 0 as well as Z is greater than 0. Hence, BN1 is AZ milli Tesla. Now we know that normal to the boundary, the equation what we have derived, BN1 is equal to BN2. Hence BN2 is equal to BN1 is equal to AZ only. Now let me calculate BT1, that is tangential component. Now we know that the total value B, that is B1 is equal to BT1 plus BN1, that is both the tangential component plus the normal component, which contributes for B value, that is B1 value. Hence, if I need only a tangential component, that is BT1, that can be written as BT1 is equal to B1 minus BN1. That is equal to. Now, what is the tangential component from the given value of B1? That is normal component we have taken as AZ. Now what is the left out? Tangential component is 2AX minus 3AY. That is the tangential component. And normal component is AZ. So we got the tangential component also as 2AX minus 3AY. Now let me calculate HT1, that is field intensity at tangential component in medium 1. So we know that B is equal to mu into H. Hence H is equal to, HT1 is equal to BT1 divided by mu 1. And BT1 value is 2AX minus 3AY into 10 to the power minus 3, because it is a milli, divided by mu 1 value. Mu 1 value is 4 into 10 to the power minus 6, because they have given in terms of micro. 4 into 10 to the power minus 6. And hence, if we solve this, we will get HT1 is equal to 500 AX minus 750 AY ampere per meter. That is the tangential component H value. So we got H tangential component we have calculated now. and both normal component of B and T we have taken directly from the given equation. Now the question is to calculate the value of B2. I need to calculate a B2. So to calculate a B2, that is BT2, I will calculate HT2 from HT1. I have calculated HT1, and using HT1, I can calculate HT2 using the tangential boundary condition, that is HT1 minus AN12 cross K. So this we have already derived the equation. That is HT1 minus HT2 is equal to K value. That is AN12 cross K. We have already seen the equation. HT1 minus HT2 is equal to K in cross AN12. We have already seen. See, HT1 minus HT2 is equal to AN12 cross K. We have already seen the equation. Hence, we will use that. That is HT2 is equal to HT1 minus AN12 cross K. Now, the HT1 value, tangential component, we have already calculated. That is 500 AX minus 750 AY substituted, and K value minus AN12, that is normal component. Normal to the surface is minus AZ. Z is less than 0. They have given for medium 2 as well as medium 1. See, medium 2, region 2 is Z is less than 0. Hence, I will write it as minus AZ cross K value. K value they have given as 88. Now I will get this equation as, since it is AZ cross AX, I will get 500 AX minus 750 AY as it is, and AZ cross AX, that is minus of, I will get it as plus 80 AY. Hence this will be my tangential component in medium 2, that is HT2. Now I got HT2. Hence, I will calculate BT2, that is tangential component in terms of flux, B value. And we know that B is equal to mu into H, that is mu2 into HT2. And mu2 value, they have given as 7 into 10 to the power minus 6. And HT2, so what is the tangential component from this? It is only again AX and AY. Hence, 500 AX minus 750 plus 80, I will get minus 670 AY. I will substitute HT2 is equal to 500 AX minus 670 AY. And that can be written as, that is equal to, I will multiply this and I will get it as 3.5 AX minus 4.69 AY millitesla. That is the value of BT2. But finally, the question is to calculate the value of B2. And B2 is equal to, it is B value is equal to both normal component as well as tangential component. That is BN2 plus BT2. BN2 we have already calculated. And this is BT2, that is BN2, we have already calculated as AZ plus AZ. And BT2 is this 3.5 AX minus 4.69 AY. Hence, the total B2, we will get it as 3.5 AX minus 4.69 AY plus AZ milli Tesla will be my, the B2 value, that is flux in the medium 2, region 2. So this is how we will do the numerical, both with respect to B as well as H, both with respect to tangential as well as normal component. Now based on this understanding of both normal and tangential component and magnetic boundary conditions, Now let us see some important questions, that is quiz questions. Let us read the question and try to substitute, fill in the blanks. First question, the tangential component of HR dash Y, the tangential component of BR dash at the boundary. What is the right answer? Is it A or B? Yes, it is A, option A. That is the tangential component of HR continuous, while the tangential component of BR discontinuous at the boundary. We have seen the boundary conditions for tangential component. Yes or no? HT1 minus HT2 is equal to K. We have derived cross AN12 also. That is the tangential component of HR continuous, while the tangential component of BR discontinuous at the boundary. Now the tangential. So what may be the value of H as well as B in case of normal component? That is the normal component of B is dash, while the normal component of H is dash at the boundary. Option B or option A. Yes, again it is option A, that is normal component of B is continuous, while the normal component of H is discontinuous at the boundary. So we have seen already, that is in case of normal component, BN1 is equal to BN2. Hence the normal component of B is continuous, wherein the normal component of H is discontinuous. So this is what which I want to cover in today's class, that is the magnetic boundary conditions. And these are the numericals what we have solved today, that is calculation of H, calculation of B, that is both tangential as well as normal component. So this is what I wanted to convey today class. Thank you. Thank you all.